Hello guys, King's Exotics 101 here today, and today I'm going to be doing a reptile room video. I'm going to be doing this video in two parts. Part one is going to be my big animals and the more smaller animals so you guys don't see a lot. Part two is going to be all of the geckos, which means crested and leopard geckos. So yeah, let's get started. Right in front of you is One-Eyed Willie. One-Eyed Willie is a five-year-old bearded dragon who I adopted about 2 or 3 months ago. He got the name One-Eyed Willie because, as you guys can see, he is missing the eye on this side of his head. The other eye is completely fine. We have him instead of an Exoterra, long, medium tank. I'm not sure the inch dimensions. All I know is that that's what it's labeled as when you buy it. He has a pretty simple setup, just the same substrate as all the other bearded dragons. Log for basking, a heat bulb on top like every bearded dragon should, and a food and water bowl. So, yeah, relatively simple. We're going to move right next door to him and go look at my ghost corn snake. This guy's name is Phantom. I'm not sure whether it's a male or female yet. I just got it about 6 months ago. As you guys can see, it is shedding very well. No problems with it. It's actually underneath its perfect hide, so... Oops, excuse me. I have this snake instead of the exact same size tank as the bearded dragon. The Exoterra long, medium size tank. Excuse me for moving around the tripod a lot, trying to get a good angle for you guys. Yeah, it's pretty good. I've had it for about 8 months now. It's looking good, moving around, handles very well, no strikes at me, anything like that. Just a good overall snake. So yeah, and then it just has the aspen bedding, because corn snakes do like to burrow a little bit. It has three hides, this is one of them. A water bowl, and a little cactus that I keep down in the corner. I know they're not from deserts, but I keep a cactus on just because it kind of looks cool, and it gives him something to rub his skin upon when he is doing shedding. So yeah, with that, I'm going to take you guys over to the other four bearded dragons and the Bhutung Skink, and we'll move through them kind of quickly. Okay. Okay, so right in front of you guys is Sandman. Sandman is my about a year and a half old bearded dragon. He's huge. I keep on saying it's a he, but actually it's a female. I was sold Sandman as a male. That's why the name is Sandman, not Sandwoman. I did not feel like changing the name. He was sold to me as a male, and I went to go get him checked out at a regular reptile breeder, and they told me it was a female. And it ended up laying some eggs for me. So I'm sure that it's female, and I'm not going to change the name just because I don't honestly feel like it. So right across from him is Hercules the Bearded Dragon. Hercules the Bearded Dragon is a 4-month-old bearded dragon, looking pretty good instead of a 20-gallon long. His tank, the front of his tank is very dirty because he goes absolutely insane whenever I come near the tank. And at night, I don't know whether he can see through glass or not, because I don't think he thinks that there's a glass wall blocking him, because at night he scratches and paws at it all for hours, trying to break out of the cage, but he never can. His tank is definitely like the most destroyed, because he likes to dig a lot, and whenever I put my hand in there, like I'll do right now just for a quick demonstration, see, he flares up, his beard's going down, yeah, he gets ready to run. No, I'm not very friendly. He got the name Hercules actually because of his aggressive nature. Hercules was a Greek fighter, one of the gods, and this guy is a huge fighter, so just the name kind of stuck. I'm going to quickly turn off the camera and move on to the next three animals. All right, so in front of you guys is Brian Jr. Brian Jr. is my 8-month-old baby, or juvenile bearded dragon. He's just about to reach adulthood. Underneath his, on his beard there, you see some red stuff. That is not blood. That is actually, I gave them some strawberries about a day ago, and the strawberries, when you give them bearded dragons, they make a mess with them, and some of the red, juices on the strawberry get onto his, throat. But yeah, he's doing good. By the way, all the bearded dragons that you see right here, except for One-Eyed Willie, are inside of 20-gallon long tanks. They all have the same substrate. The only real differences are the food and water bowl types and the hide types. So all the tanks are very similar and very easy. And leave in the comments below if you guys want me to do a bearded dragon video. Coming right on across from him, I have a rack system underneath my loft bed, actually. That's why they're all facing each other. We have Spike. Spike is the oldest reptile in my room. This is my three... Well, the oldest, the reptile that I've had the most. The oldest is actually Willie. But this is my 3-year-old bearded dragon. It is a male, which I'm really proud of. and happy to have, because that means I can breed them to Sandman, as you guys saw above. And like I said, Sandman produced eggs. However, he laid them on a weekend where I was at my cottage, and because of this, the eggs were infertile because the heat light practically burned them. It kind of sucks, but I'm hoping once Sandman puts on some more weight, I'm going to retry to breed them and hopefully get some babies out of them. I'm going to quickly cut, and we're going to move on to my Merake Blue Tongue Skink. Okay, so on the ground in front of you is my Merake Blue Tongue Skink. He's inside of a 40-gallon breeder. He has two hides, a water bowl, and a substrate consisting of reptile bark. We feed him dog food every other day. We try to get him to eat some romaine lettuce, but he hardly ever eats it, but I do still put it in his bowl every day. I've had this guy for about 6 months. When I bought him, they told me that he was, or excuse me, not 6 months, like 3 months. And when I bought him, the people who I bought it from told me he was 9 weeks old at the time. So this guy is roughly 4 or 5 months old now. He's doing pretty good. His weight does need to go up a lot. Or not a lot, a little bit, because he spends a lot of time underneath his black hide. You guys can't see it. But he spends all of his time underneath his black hide when it's flipped over normal. And he never comes out for food. So I constantly have to move the food to him. I think he might be a little stressed because, like I said, all my animals are underneath a loft bed, so they're all facing each other. I think the two bearded dragons that are looking down at him and the other two that are looking straight at him may stress him out. So I did recently buy some 50-gallon tank, like a fish tank side lines. That's what you use on the back of a fish tank so you don't see straight through it. And I'm going to put those on the sides of his tank to prevent the bearded dragons from staring him, and hopefully he'll become more active. So, yeah, that's him. We're going to move on to the next. Okay, so next up is my male Green and Null. I will put a couple pictures of him in after I finish filming this because it's kind of hard for you guys to see him. It's a bad angle. But, yeah, I've had this guy for roughly 8 months now. Very good. He's brown-looking right now because, in case you guys don't know, when Green and Nulls get stressed out, they turn from a green to brown. Very common thing, not a health issue. He's kind of starting to relax. That's why the green's starting to come back towards his underbelly. He's looking good. He's eating crickets and mealworms. His tank is an Exoterra tall, small tank. I'm, once again, not sure about the whole dimensions. He has a nice log right here for basking that he usually ends up sleeping on. Down there is his little food bowl. I have it raised up because I noticed that when I had his food bowl on the ground, he wasn't going down towards it to eat. He would only eat when I tong fed him up higher, so I put a higher up food bowl, and he actually started eating it. I have a water bowl, and then I have this green plant right here that I just took out because he kept on hiding it when I was trying to get a good film. So yeah, we're moving on to our final reptile that I'm going to show you guys today, and then we'll do part two. I'll post that one tomorrow after this video. Okay, so the last reptile is actually my most recent addition. This is my female albino ball python. I got this girl for Christmas this year, which is, upon the time me posting this video, probably about 2 weeks ago. She does have some stuck shed on the top of her skin right there and right there. I do know that. This is my first time actually having her shed, because, like I said, I just got her. She's in due for a hot water bath. She normally looks a lot prettier, but like I said, she is having a shedding problem right now, so I'm going to put her inside of a hot bath probably immediately after this video. I'll put her inside of the hot bath and actually put a couple pictures of her in the bath and after the bath end of the video, like in the end credits there. So yeah, this is her. I do not have a male, and this is a baby, a juvenile. But I'm actually kind of happy, because once this girl gains more weight and gets much, much bigger, I would like to start breeding ball pythons. If you guys pay attention to my channel, you'll notice that there are a lot of woods going around. Like, oh, when I get older, I'm going to do this, and I'm hoping I'm going to do this. Just right now, I'm 14. I'm a freshman in high school, so I don't have the funds that I currently need on my own to buy everything and to do everything that I want to do. So I have to wait until I get into college or out of college before I can actually start the big projects like breeding ball pythons for more money than I currently am making from like the crested geckos. So yeah, that's the end of the video. Like I said, I'm going to post a picture of the green and null not having, or being fully green and instead of a better angle. And I'm going to post a picture of this girl inside of the tub taking her warm water bath, and a picture of her after the warm water bath to show the change. So yeah, thanks for watching. Any of the animals inside of this video that you guys like and you want me to do a specific care video on, go ahead and comment down below. I have a lot of common animals, so I think a lot of you guys know how to deal with them, but if you don't, go ahead and comment down below. So, yeah. And then part two of this, where I do all my geckos, will come around tomorrow. Right. So, I know I said I'd post a picture, but I'm just going to post a quick video. Sorry for the echo I am inside of my bathroom. I put her inside of the water. A bunch of it fell off, as you guys can see. But she's had her fill. She doesn't want to be in the water anymore. Every time I put her in, she starts freaking out and climbs back on top of the faucet. So, I mean, yeah, see, she's very eager to get out. I think she's had enough, but she's looking much, much better. Good. Thank you guys for watching, and like and subscribe.